Tom, were you Mize? Were you?
Mize, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And with Katie?
Darkly.
Clay. And what other schools?
Darkly.
Lockheegish.
Carrie T, but
I probably won't be telling stories. Carrie T? Yeah. Because his first cousin was my teacher.
Oh! Duffy.
That was my first teacher, so I'm out of the.
That was my an uncle that used to teach in that school in Carrie T.
That's right. Oh, right.
Mm. He was the principal and she was the assistant.
Is the school still there?
No, there were four or five schools and they're all amalgamated into one separate school.
Right.
I was in Carrigatee, she was there, another one, Kilkit.
And it was the same, would it be 20, 25 or 20, many would be in the list, like?
I'd say an average of about 30 in each one.
The reason I'm down here is to see what I can learn, because we're actually doing a similar project on Kilkit, a school reunion.
Oh, that's right, yeah, I remember
it. It's closed from 1976, and all the five schools, as Tom says, there was five schools in the parish, and the five of them are closed, one central school in Lochmorland. So Lara and Lagan have already had reunions. Mm-hmm. Amy Kerr had one this year. Carrigatee is the only one that's left. Kilkit, we've talked about Kilkit for the last 10 or 12 years, so eventually got round, a year after the gathering, we got round to do
it. Oh, very good.
And funny, that's because we have to do various things like what we're doing here, and we have to do musical events and cross-community and cross-border events,
yeah,
and stuff like that. And it's hard, when it's all new, it's hard to know what to do or to get ideas. So that's what took me down to get ideas. But when you mentioned John Timbert, our first teacher that I would have known all my way through Kilkit was Hugh Hughes from Braddocks. He was the principal teacher in Hugh Hughes. He was the principal teacher for years and years and years. He came in, it was his first job when he qualified from St. Pat's or wherever he qualified from. He came in about 1958 or 9. And he was there for a long, long time. He got involved then. He moved to Dublin and Portobello College in Dublin. He was one of the founders of Portobello College. He's still alive.
Yeah.
He's about, he's probably around 80 years of age. He played with Clontibret and won the county championships with Clontibret.
Hughes, do you know
him? No. Hugh from Ballasmill.
No,
he was Hugh Hughes.
He says that's you. He's brother James.
I think he has brother James.
Yes. Yeah.
And
his sister was married to Pat Macklin.
Mary. Well, that's James Hughes' date there, was that there?
No, James is still, that was another James Hughes.
Yeah.
You know him, Pat. You know James,
the
Huntsman.
That's not the
man. You know for sure.
In Katie, is it?
No. Larry Macklin's.
I do, yeah.
Well, just
brother
up Tommy. The hill from Larry Macklin's was where Hugh Hughes was. And Joe McMahon's was at the end of the lane.
Was that where Big James Hughes
came
from?
No, Big James Hughes came from all out at the end of that road.
Aye.
They had a rented house off Bernard Welsh.
Right.
Hughes was back in the road from Jack Ross's Cross. The road back from Jack Ross's Cross down to Ned Lennon's, as they called it. Down near where the quarry is now.
Yeah.
That's where, and Hugh Hughes lived on that by road.
Oh.
Well, he was our principal teacher.
Yeah.
And what's more, we can claim credit for. We didn't wash them, but we dried the Clontibret jerseys many times. He carried them around with him in the car. He was probably one of the few people that had a car at the time, but he'd have the baggy jerseys, and he used to hang them out at Kilkit school to get them dried.
These were the lucky charm.
I would never won a senior championship, but we dried the jerseys.
What did they call the school that's down at the chapel?
It's a dwelling house now, it's converted into a dwelling house. They had a reunion.
Well, my mother went to that school.
Yeah.
Amy Kerr.
Yeah.
That's a long time ago.
There's no one in Derry News. No one here went to Derry News. No.
No, but you see, there was no such thing as St. Bacour's and maybe.
It was just
Derry News Primary School, and that was it. Mm. It's only in years later that they started to, whenever the first school was opened, and even then it was only years after some Holy Joes thought it would be better to call it St. McCowers. And then there was other Holy Joes, and then they called it Our Ladies, St. McCowers and Our Ladies. They could have maybe...
Half a dozen names.
They could have put half a dozen names on it. But it doesn't matter now.